In this video, I will cover placing and editing ramps in Home Designer. The stair ramp tool is available in both Home Designer Architectural and Home Designer Professional. The professional version of the product has a few more ramp options, which I'll cover at the end of the video. I'll begin by opening up a completed plan and take a 3D view by using the 3D camera to create a perspective view. Then I'll tile my screen so you can see both the 2D and the 3D views. To tile the views, I'll click and grab the 3D window and drag it out until I see the blue area indicating where the view will be. And then I can drop it into place. I'll also zoom in on the plan and the 3D view using my scroll wheel on my mouse to zoom in. In the plan view, I'll choose Build, Stairs, Ramp. Ramps are drawn and configured similar to stairs. With the ramp tool selected, I can click and drag to draw a ramp. The ramp will draw at a 1 in 12 slope, which is the typical ADA requirement for ramps. I can then increase or decrease the size of the ramp by either selecting the ramp and adjusting the edit handles, or by double-clicking to open up the ramp and typing in the length and the width. Either way, the slope should remain at 1 in 12. So, if I draw a 10-foot ramp, that's 120 inches, the overall height should be 10 inches. To create an L-shaped ramp, I'll use the ramp tool and click and drag an additional ramp. Notice in 3D, both ramps are at ground level. To connect them, I'll use the ramp tool and click in the space between the two ramps. The program will then automatically create an automatic landing to join the two ramp segments. The ramp landing will use the thickness and material of the ramps, so it will be concrete at the ground level. You can shape ramp landings as your design may require. With the ramp edge selected, in the lower edit toolbar, I'll use Change Line to Arc to curve the landing edge for a larger turn radius. To edit both of the ramp segments, I'll select the first ramp and hold down my Shift key and then click to select the second ramp. Then in my lower edit toolbar, I'll use the Open Object tool. In the ramp dialog, you can change the width and length of the ramp. If you see no change, it's because the values of these ramps will vary. You can simply type a value in to make the adjustment when that's the case. In Home Designer Pro, you will find added height and slope control for the ramps, and I'll cover that here in just a minute. You'll find a setting for your ramps to be open underneath the ramp thickness and an option to add a tread to the ramp. On the railing panel, you can set the height of the railing, control the railing for the right and left sides, and then the type of railing. For this ramp, I'll use an open style and remove the bottom rail. On the newels and balusters panel, you can change the style of the railing. And on the materials panel, you can adjust the materials for the various ramp components. As I close the ramp dialog, you'll see all the changes that were applied in 3D. And because I changed the ramp width, I'll need to adjust the landing to fit. Once I do, it will automatically reconnect the landing to this ramp segment. Let's create a new ramp. Earlier when I created the ramp by clicking and dragging, for this ramp, I can just click outside the porch railing and Home Designer will draw the ramp at the exact length it needs to be to reach the porch from the terrain and maintain a 1 in 12 slope. It will also automatically place an opening in the porch railing. I can use the edit handles to move its location. To make the ramp integrated seamlessly into the porch, I'll reposition it and I'll need to lower it to the ground level. The ramp will want to sit on top of the porch, so I can either reshape the porch room or I could create an open-to-blow room inside the porch, like you would for a stairwell. To create this stairwell type of approach, I'll use the room divider wall type and then open up the room dialog and change it to an open to below room, which will then remove the floor platform and allow the stairs to drop to ground level. I'll adjust the opening that was created in the railing and make it wide enough for the ramp. Home Designer Professional includes added ramp features for more control over the height and slope. For example, if I open up the previous ramp's upper segment and remove the automatic height setting, I can make some manual adjustments. In this case, I can change the top height, press the Tab key, and you'll notice that the slope will automatically recalculate. In Home Designer Professional, you have the manual controls over the location of the ramp, and I can create shallower and steeper pitches as the situation may require. To learn more about ramps, please see our built-in help file and our support articles available on the Home Designer Software website. And thanks for watching the video.